15 years after then-Attorney General Dan Siapin brought the first legislation on domestic violence to the House entitled the Domestic Violence Summary Proceedings Act, the Minister of Health and Social Development moved a motion during the September 6th sitting of the House of Assembly for the second and third readings of the bill entitled Domestic Violence Act 2011. Minister Penn explained that the bill was drawn up from a draft OECS bill, which was adapted to meet the needs of the territory. She outlined some of the goals the bill seeks to accomplish, which include broadening the definition of domestic violence to include harassment, stalking, and economic abuse, among other things.
Among the things that this bill does, Mr. Speaker, and I'll get a little more specific as we go on, is that it will broaden the definition of domestic violence to include economic abuse, intimidation, harassment, stalking, and damage to and destruction of property. In addition, the bill would offer protection to persons in visiting relationships which are not covered in the present legislation. But we all know, because we live in our society and we know it, there are relationships which are visiting relationships. The persons don't necessarily live together all of the time. The bill would now cover those kinds of relationships. It gives police officers certain duties and obligations. For example, a police officer arriving at the scene of an incident of domestic violence is given a legal duty. The law, the bill says that the police officer has a duty to inform both the victim and the perpetrator of his or her rights under the law. And importantly, it provides for an arrest by a police officer without a warrant where, in the officer's view, domestic violence has occurred, if the officer has a suspicion.
Raising some concerns on the Domestic Violence Act 2011, Dr. Kedrick Pickering spoke on Section 4, which says that an arrest can be made by an officer without a warrant once there is suspicion of domestic violence.
Mr. Speaker, I have a real issue with Section 4. Arrest by a police officer without a warrant. I have a real problem with that. Subject to Section 20, a police officer may arrest without warrant any person at the scene of an incident of domestic violence whom he or she reasonably suspects of having committed an act of domestic violence. That police officer might got a beef with you and help provoke the problem also. Mr. Speaker, there's a lot of lessons to be learned from recent events that we see in the media, how the overreaching of the law can cause problems for other people. I heard a very senior lawyer in the United States in a very high profile trial say that unless you've been in it, you don't understand what it means to be in the throes of the criminal justice system. If once somebody arrests you, you gotta get a lawyer. It costs money. And if you're already in a difficult financial situation, you have to go now find money to defend yourself. It might have been, you know, a situation that could easily have been blown out of proportion.
Dr. Pickering said that the bill must also address the issue of blogging. As he said, we live in an era of breaking news, and the online blogs at times go as far as to reveal the identity of minors in some of these cases. Members of the House supported the bill and commended the minister on moving to have it acted upon as soon as possible, including Minister for Communication and Works, Julian Fraser, who said that terming the problem as domestic violence is misleading, as he said there is much more going on behind closed doors and therefore it should be termed domestic abuse. Minister Fraser spoke of what he called deadbeat dads who do not offer financial support, and he said that this too is abuse.
Mr. Speaker, this is a time in this society and in the world, which by extension came down to our society, where abuse is commonplace in the household. Mr. Speaker, I speak of nothing short of the economic situation in the world that has found itself in the household and is meting out abuse upon our people. Mr. Speaker, what do you say about a deadbeat dad that doesn't support his children, our child? Isn't that indeed abuse? It comes to me face, comes to me to my face regularly, Mr. Speaker, in this society that which, in which I live and which we all live. And my colleagues are no different. They're in the same boat as I'm in. 9 out of 10 people coming to you for assistance, Mr. Speaker, are women.
The House passed the Domestic Violence Act 2011 with amendments on September 6, 2011.